So the number of rows is the number of objects, and that is 7. And the number of columns is the total sum of all the values. So 2 plus 3 plus 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus 5 plus 2, which is 24. So we have 7 rows and 24 columns in this table. We're going to fill this out row by row. So we start out in row 1, then row 2, and so on. So for row I and column j, what we want in this table is the minimum size required to achieve a value of exactly j using the objects 1 to I. Now, in the first row, we only have the first object available. So the only thing that we can achieve is a value of 2 using size 3. So value of 2 using size 3, and all of the other ones are just not possible. Second row, we have two objects available. We have objects A and B available. So what we can achieve is a value of 2, a value of 3, and a value of 5. Now, for a value of 2, we need size 3 again. For a value of 3, we can do that with size 2. And for a value of 5, we need size 5. And I'll fill out one more row here for you. I'm not going to show you the part that goes beyond 8, though, because that'll not be important for what I'm about to explain. The interesting part here is this one here, because object number 3 has size 4 and value 5, which means that we can achieve value 5 actually by putting in this object, instead of using A and B as we did in the row before. Let's go to row 4, because in row 4 I can show you something very interesting. First values are actually not that interesting. So remember that in this row here, row number 4, we now have available to us object A, object B, object C, and object D. If we were to go through the whole table, how efficiently can we fill out this table? And now that we have D available here in row number 4, I can show you something very interesting, because you can fill out this table quite efficiently. Now here we are in the column labeled 7, which means we want to achieve a value of 7. How can we achieve a value of 7? So we already know that we can achieve a value of 7 using these three objects, A, B, C, because we have this row here. Now, what are the different possibilities of achieving a value of 7? We could either do this through the row above, because we know that we can achieve it using objects A, B, and C. So it could be row above. We could also try to take D directly, but D has a value of 4, so here that's not possible. So take the new object. And finally, there's only a third possibility here. Well, since D has a value of 4, we could try to achieve a value of 3 using the objects we had in there before, and then add D to it. So add D to another set, and that is a set of size 3. And we know, just from looking at this table here, that with size 2, we can already achieve a value of 3. D has a value of 4, and it has a size of 5, so 2 plus 5 is 7, which is actually now the same as this one here. But of course, you would be taking the minimum of the required sizes. So here, we would enter a 7. The interesting part is this. In order to fill this cell here, we do not need to go through all possible combinations of the objects that we have. We just need to consider three cases, each of which can be calculated in constant time if we have the row previous to the row that we're trying to fill out.